Hello and welcome back to my Let's Play of the Latin Empire in Wars 4, where we're having a bit of a difficult war, because I'm bad. But, you know, I think Azerbaijan's gonna die a little. He's gonna lose this at the very least. But I have to take... no. That's what I want. The other 55 war score can go towards various other things. Now, my current troops are a little battered. Exhausted, really. I guess you could say that anyway, but... why the hell are you... Pereyaslav, you're making me take even more fucking attrition. Why must you do this? But anyway, I gain nearly 1,000 a month, so I can sort of live to an extent on quite a considerable amount. Let's move you to Tech and you to Karaman. You to Konya. I'm going to get ready to make a move against them in the Drylands. Is he... he's going to get in my way? No? This guy's a cannoneer. When... before cannons were good. And I don't have to upgrade any troops now, do I? Not yet. The troop upgrade comes on the next tech, I see. Okay, let's see. What is the current dates these two would arrive on if I were to attack them now? Because 40,000 up against that should be a considerable victory. 15th? 9th. Okay. So you have to wait a few days. I don't know how many, but you have to wait a few. Okay, two more. This will all arrive on the same day and should prove quite significant. Now, as they've been pretty much fully sieged over here, they're going to help. Yeah, you are not going to have a good time because they're going to be heavily outnumbered for a little bit. And I do trust that they can win, considering they've got brilliant generals and like me. They may have a penalty, but I think they're more than making up for that. That there, meanwhile, was rather successful. Azerbaijan then sent his army in. Slightly outnumbered here, and I've got cannons and he hasn't, so that's actually gonna... of course he rolls well, but, you know, he's still gonna lose pretty severely. So that's reduced my dwindling manpower supplies even further, but it's really just battered them back twice. They've lost over here as well. So the war participation is definitely heavily in my favour. And they've just sieged that there. As Azerbaijan continues to crumble, I want them to annul those treaties and also give up all of this here. Yeah, Kharkov works. So, giving that to Pereyaslav would work quite well. It means they lose a bit of land. A 100,000 troops on one province. Are you sure you want to take that attrition, though? Considering my current situation, I am a little pressed for manpower. I might use the estate for once, but just how much would they give? Not a bad amount, but the manpower recovery speed, I want to keep that for a while longer yet. That's occupied by me. These are all Piraeus Lav. Because we're nearly the same colour, that's the issue here. So he's given that to me at least. Which I'm happy about. Let's pull. Yeah, he's already there. Shit. It was like a day or two late, but you know, could be worse. Let's move you up to the front, because I may as well still have you up there. Now, this is going to probably be very heavy on each side, really. So, they'll suffer a lot of aggressive expansion, but I think they can handle it. Plus, their aggressive expansion is almost certainly... Well, it's 47. Azerbaijan may be pissed, but what are they going to do? Sue them? Yeah, pretty much no one but Novgorod is going to care. Maybe Pskov, but, you know, they're over there. And messages, but I'm not even going to tell them to go for now. So, I just battered their fleet around some more, and now it's here, and it's going to get battered again. I'm going to get the recovery tick this month, and then I'm going to go back out there. Manpower is dwindling, but it's starting to hit the point where it may recover. Considering Azerbaijan's position, once they're out, I will definitely be having a bit of fun. Now, I do not want to test my luck. In terms of what will exactly occur. And let's see. The game's now not responding. Now it is. So what really needs to be done is Azerbaijan has to lose land. And that's what's going to happen. Here they're going to be losing a 21 development, a 9 development, a 7 development, alongside 5 development. $71,000 versus me in mountains. This is gonna break my manpower permanently, I think. But guess who's gonna be helping with a god tier leader? Rostislav. We won. But at what cost? Pull the damaged armies back. Oh boy, he's going here now. Isn't that just rude? I want to swing around through my own land, because really, I would rather just have one get there immediately. Guess what? Pereyaslav is coming in. And it's going to be much more staggered, really, when I think about it. Okay, that fort just fell. That's brilliant. And that just turned the war score around completely. So, several massive victories for us. Now, a lot of their army is up here busy sieging this, but it's not going to last much longer. Spread the armies out a bit to avoid extreme attrition, which I just took. Ow. But guess what? They're loitering about here as well. Phew. And also, I'm going to do this now because I can't. Jesus Christ, that's more expensive than I expected. What's staying here? Some small Pereans. Oh boy, what is going on here? I wonder when he'll take his peace deal. Yeah, you're gonna be a bit broken when I'm done with you. And this is revenge for being such a pain in the ass. So there goes his capital. My manpower is completely and utterly destroyed. I'm gaining. He's sieging down here still. Letting his homeland just be fully sieged up. Oh my. Can go to speed free, I think. For the matter, I'm gonna dock the fleet up. And, well, I think I can recover some of the manpower I have at least. I'll help here. I help. Ongoing battle, so look, you're good because you have an army. Now, I think what's going to occur is pretty simple. Pereyaslav is going to get down here with that big army there, and he's just going to suddenly start demolishing shit. Manpower deficit I'm currently running is shrinking, and I wouldn't have it right now if I had actually been smart at the start of the war, but I wasn't. I was just a very stupid idiot. I like he has like a plus siege general and whatnot, and it's just annoying. Well, it doesn't really affect me much, does it? Why is the supply limit here so shit? I don't get it. I know it's a low development province, but that's still surprisingly fucking awful. This year apparently pisses them off really badly. Oh, Pereyaslav got declared on, did he? Yeah, it's all disintegrating for him. It's the end of his. This is going to be Azbajane's peak, and I'm going to make sure that it falls. And I make sure it falls heavily. Someone needs to get to its capital, but to be honest, at the rate he's going, he's going to be... Yeah, war exhaustion in both of these nations is driving right on up. I doubt they're going to be doing too well after this war. And I'm too hesitant to engage 50,000, well, probably close to 60,000, really, of their troops down here. Especially when I have no manpower and they're using mercenaries. So, Shirvan has been occupied by Poland. We should drop off some of these. I could get it very close right now. Prioritize these up here, I guess. But each lost battle for him is really just breaking him a bit more each time. I mean, you'd set that right now. But I want that, because that gives slightly better borders. And the more of them that's occupied, the better. Could give these guys Crimea. But you can't tell where what I've occupied started, or what they've given to me starts, and where theirs ends. This is me, this is them. Oh no. It is literally identical. And now they're getting carpet sieged, because they're utterly boned. A few more provinces occupied and they'll be out. For good. This pretty much just wrecked Azerbaijan, and I think more people may pounce on them after this. But they do still have an army. It's just it's not a very strong army. You know what, I'm going to contribute down here, but why in the hell were Poland doing so well for a second there? I don't get it, but okay. I'll try and arrive on time, because I think they do need it. Oh no, this isn't good. This could go very poorly. Or it could actually go alright. I avenged our Polish brethren. I almost had a heart attack then. Demetrius. So, would you want this? Umay. Yes, you would. You wouldn't take Kharkov, but that is... So, yeah, you'll see those to Pereyaslav. You'll see these to me. Your annual treaties with Egypt and the Gurids, and so on and so on. So they should be negotiating for themselves. Let's send it. Jesus Christ, the losses on both sides is absurd. Conquer Guria. Now, do I take this? Azerbaijan and Rum can't enter a coalition. Gazimurk and Egypt can. If I were to take every bit of money they had. Yeah, I'm gonna try and bankrupt them. So let's do it. The losses are frigging horrendous, though. Just horrendous. Oh my. So, having taken severe losses during that war, I'm going to try and convert as much of this as possible, but let's end this. So, thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time, where we shall see what we can do. Now that we have conquered our new bit of land, we're going to have to spend at least 10 years recovering from this, because we have indeed taken quite the considerable battering. But the breaking of the alliance between Egypt, the Gurids, and Azerbaijan is probably going to prove as a very significant turning point in their survival. Either way, thank you for watching, and I shall see you next time. Bye for now.